and will. You see that they are connected together. They are the two ends of that rod. If thou, on the one hand, will obey the voice of the Lord your God and do all that I speak, it says, then I will be an enemy to thine enemies. If you will obey the word of God and thank God as children of God, you obey the word of God. I said you obey the word of God. And as you do that, and he says, seest thou, and if thou will do this, then I will be an enemy to your enemy. God will fight your enemies for you. And an adversary unto thine adversaries. I'm looking at Deuteronomy chapter 28. Deuteronomy chapter 28. Remember what we're looking for? If thou, then I will. In Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 1. And it shall come to pass, if thou, you see that, it's always there. And it is always the first part, the human part. The Lord wants to see our commitment unto him so that he can shovel and he can flow the blessings of God into our lives. And it shall come to pass, if thou shalt hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe and to do all that, all his commandments which I command thee this day, that the Lord thy God will. That's the same thing, I will. The Lord thy God will set thee on high above all the nations of the earth. Promotion has come. Exaltation has come. Increase has come in your life in Jesus' name. If thou, then I will. Pursue, and all these blessings shall come on thee and overtake thee. If thou shalt hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, blessings will run after you. Verse 7, the Lord shall cause thine enemies that rise up against thee to be smitten before thy face, and they shall come out, they shall come out against thee one way, and flee before thee, how many ways? Seven ways. The Lord shall command the blessings upon thee in all thy storehouses, and in all that thou settest thine hand unto, he shall bless thee in the land which the Lord thy God giveth thee. Verse 9, the Lord shall establish thee and holy people unto himself, as he has sworn unto thee, if thou shalt keep the commandments of the Lord thy God and walk in his ways, and all the people of the earth shall see that thou art called by the name of the Lord, and they shall be what? Afraid of thee. And the Lord shall make thee plenteous in goods, in the fruit of thy body. You are not barren anymore. I said you are not barren anymore. In the fruit of thy cattle, and in the fruit of thy ground, in the land which the Lord sware unto thy fathers to give thee, the Lord shall open unto thee his good treasure, the heavens to give the rain unto thy land in his season, and to bless all the work of thine hand. How many parts of your work will the Lord bless? All. And thou shalt lend unto many nations, and thou shalt not borrow. And the Lord shall make thee the head and not the tail. Anywhere you are in your family, you'll be the head and not the tail. in your company, in your corporation, you'll be the head and not the tail. In your school, in your education, you'll be the head and not the tail. In your profession, you will be the head, you will not be the tail. Because the Lord said, if thou, when you're hearken to the word, and you're obedient to the word, and you give your heart and your life unto the Lord, if thou, then God says, then I will. It will so promote you and exalt you, and nothing will be impossible in your life anymore in Jesus' name. And thou shalt be above only. January till December, thou shalt be above only. 1 year to another year, thou shalt be above only. From a bachelor to a married man, thou shalt be above only. From a spinster to a married woman, a wife, thou shalt be above only. And with your children, the family will be above only. And thou shalt not be beneath. I thought you'd say amen to that. If thou hearken unto the commandments of the Lord thy God, which I command thee this day to observe and to do them. You see what the Lord is telling us? If thou, then I will. 1 Kings chapter 3. In 1 Kings chapter 3, I'm reading from verse 14. And remember what we're looking for, those words, if thou, I will. If thou, I will. In 1 Kings chapter 3, verse 14. And if thou will walk in my ways and keep my statutes and my commandments, as thy father David did walk, then I will lengthen thy days. There are some people that are asking, how can they live long? Here is a secret. How is it? What will I do? What will I eat? How will I live? What kind of exercise should I get involved in? How do I modify my diet so that I will live long? Listen, the Lord has a plan for you that you will live long. I said the Lord has a plan for you that you will live long. But now he says, if thou, then I will. And isn't it very simple, verse 14? If thou wilt walk in my ways. Thank God you have decided to walk in the ways of the Lord. You will live long. I said you will live long, because the Lord said, if thou, then I will, if thou wilt walk in my ways and keep my commandments and my covenant and my commandments, as thy father David did walk, then I. This is a commitment of the Almighty God. This is the covenant of the Almighty God. This is the pronouncement, irreversible, irrevocable pronouncement of the Lord, that if you will do this and keep on walking and keep on living according to the commandments of the Lord, then the Lord said, I will lengthen thy days. In 1 Kings chapter 6, 1 Kings chapter 6, we're looking at verse 12. Remember again, if thou, then I will. If thou, then I will. 1 Kings chapter 6, verse 12. Concerning this house which thou art in building, if thou wilt walk in my statutes and execute my judgments and keep all my commandments to walk in them, then I will perform my word with thee. You see that? If thou, as a human being, as a child of God, a child, an obedient child in the family, a faithful child in the family, a loyal servant in the ministry, a disciple of the Lord Jesus Christ, a dependable disciple of the Lord Jesus Christ, following the Lord, following the Lord, following the Lord. If thou wilt walk in my statutes and execute my judgments and keep all my commandments to walk in them, then when I perform my words for thee, which I spake unto David thy father, the Lord himself will be with you. And I will dwell among the children of Israel. I will not forsake my people Israel. The Lord will not forsake us. You in particular, the Lord will not forsake you. He has seen your interest in following the Lord. He has seen your desire in serving the Lord. He has seen your consecration in obeying the commandments of the Lord. He has seen your earnestness in wanting to live how God wants you to live. And he has seen how you desire the grace of God abundantly in your life to live the life he has laid and run the race he has laid before you. And he says, because of that passion in your heart, that desire in your soul to live according to his word, he said, he will bless you and you are blessed in Jesus' name. In 1 Kings chapter 11, I'm reading from verse 38. 1 Kings 11:38. And it shall be, if thou, you see that, it's everywhere. If thou wilt hearken unto all that I command thee, and will walk in my ways, and do that is right in my sight, to keep my statutes and my commandments, as David my servant did, that I will be with thee. You see on the one hand, if thou, and then you see on the other hand, I will. If thou wilt walk in the commandments of the Lord, and you will live according as he has declared in his word, then he says, then I will be with thee. The Lord will be with you. He will never leave you. He will never forsake you. So you may boldly say, you will not be afraid. What can man do unto you? And build thee a sure house, as I built for David, and will give Israel unto thee. Jeremiah chapter 15. We want to see what the Lord is reminding us of. And he says, if thou, then I will. Jeremiah chapter 15, we're looking at verse 19. This is wonderful. Therefore, thus says the Lord, if thou return, then I will bring thee again. If thou return. And you know, sometimes somebody gets confused and battered and unhappy. And because he could not see the provision of the Lord, he went away, he backslid. And the Lord is saying, I want to bless you, I'm waiting for you. And if thou shalt return, then I will bring thee again. And thou shalt stand before me. You will stand before the Lord again. You will serve the Lord again. You will harvest the blessings of the Lord again. But you know, you cannot just sit back there and say, if God wants to bless him, let him bless me. You will do like the prodigal son. I will arise and go unto my father, and I will say, Father, I have sinned against heaven and against you. I'm not worthy to be called your child. Once you say that and you come, the Lord will receive you. If thou, then I will. Look at verse 20. And I will make thee unto this people a fenced prison wall. The Lord will protect you. He shall fight against you, but he shall not prevail against you. I thought you were saying amen to that. If you return to the Lord and thank God, we have returned. I said we have returned. Why are we here if we have not returned? Why did you come if you have not returned? There's something in your heart saying, I want to connect with God again. I want to see the power, the provision of the Lord in my life once again. There's something in your heart that desires. I want to be the best I can be in the kingdom. That's why I'm here. You have returned. And as you have returned, the blessings of God will be multiplied in your life in Jesus' name. Then it says that, for I am with thee to save thee and to deliver thee, says the Lord. In verse 21, and I will deliver thee out of the hand of the wicked. If thou, that's all the condition. That's man's responsibility. And this is God's promise. That if thou shall return with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind, then it says, I will deliver thee out of the hand of the wicked. I will redeem thee out of the hand of the terrible. It has happened already. I said it has happened already. Zechariah chapter 3, verse 7. If thou, then I will. Zechariah chapter 3, we're looking at verse 7. Thus says the Lord of hosts, if thou wilt walk in my ways. You can see that from all these scriptures that we read. You see the first end of the line, and then you see the last end of the line. The first end of the line, if thou wilt walk in my ways, when you promise the Lord, when you covenant with the Lord, when you consecrate unto the Lord, you say, Lord, forgive me all the past instability. And forgive me, Lord, all the past inconsistencies. And forgive me, Lord, the past insensibility to your word. But now I'm making up my mind, I can see. If thou wilt do this, then this is what you promised that you will do. And then you're going to make a new commitment of your life unto the Lord, of your will, your mind, your obedience, and your consecration unto the Lord. Then the Lord says, if you will do that, then this is what I will do. As you become faithful to the Lord and say, Lord, I've had your word, and I'm going to do according to your word, the Lord will not disappoint you in Jesus' name. I said a lot of I will in your life. He has pronounced blessing upon you, and that blessing will come in Jesus' name. Look at that again. Thus says the Lord of hosts, if thou wilt walk in my ways, and if thou wilt keep my charge, then thou shalt judge my house, and shall also keep my cause, and I will give thee places to walk among these that stand by. The Lord is saying he'll give you an exalted place, an important place, a respectable place in the midst of the people of God. Number one, the discovery of his healing provision. Number two, the declaration of his heavenly presence. Number three, the demonstration. Didn't he say, I will? That I will assures us of the demonstration of his healing power. Demonstration. Everybody say demonstration. He will demonstrate it in your life. He'll put it into your life. And the blessings of God that will flow into your life and enrich your heart, that blessing will be so wonderful today, you will have more than you are requesting in Jesus' name. the demonstration of his healing power. We're looking at Numbers chapter 21. Numbers chapter 21. I'm reading from verse 8 and from verse 9. Numbers chapter 21, verse 8. And the Lord said unto Moses, make thee a fiery serpent, and set it upon a pole. And it shall come to pass that everyone, how many people? How many people? You know, many people, when they don't read the Bible very well, they say, yes, I know God is healing the sick. I know God is delivering their prayers. But how about me, everyone? And this includes you. I said this includes you. Everyone, everyone, everyone. Thank God this morning, everyone. I said thank God this morning, everyone. The sicknesses are healed. The oppression is taken away. All your discouragement is gone in Jesus' name. That everyone that is bitten, when he looketh upon it, shall live. And Moses made a serpent of brass and put it upon a pole. And it came to pass that if a serpent had bitten any man, when he beheld the serpent of brass, he lived. And thank God that includes you, you are going to live. In fact, we are told in John chapter 3, John chapter 3, telling us the lesson we need to learn from that event that took place. For the children of Israel were the lifted up brazen serpent, that everyone that beheld, every one of them lived. John chapter 3 verse 14. And as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, even so must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whosoever. In the Old Testament it says everyone. In the New Testament it says whosoever. That's the same thing. That means you, that means me, that means every one of us. I'm just thanking God for you, because this morning is the morning of your blessing. That whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. It even goes beyond healing. Salvation is yours this morning. Blessings are yours this morning. Healing is yours this morning. Eternal life is yours this morning in Jesus' name. And then in Isaiah chapter 53.